So I previously looked before at both Magneto and Wolverine from the X-Men 97 range, and we're going to take a look today at Bishop and Storm. Just to give you a brief look at some of the figures and how they may all scale and fit together, certainly with Wolverine, he makes the most notable difference. You can see quite a bit shorter than Bishop and Storm itself. Wolverine, the last time, I mean, he's coming in at really bang on 6 inches, nearly the top of his ears there, so about 15 centimetres. Bishop's coming in nearly 7 inches tall, or 18 centimetres, and the same for Storm. She's pretty high with that crest of hair, 6¾ inches, or 17 centimetres tall. They're pretty big figures, but at least to show you with the other two ones that I had on the Marvel Legends shelf, I thought we'd give you a closer look at these just to kind of see the difference in what's going on there. One noticeable thing is the heads are swappable with Storm, so there's still a lot of compatibility in terms of the size and structure of them. And you can see Bishop, even though he's a brand new figure, he is quite different in both style and execution from transfer on the shoulder, which is not there, to the very orange comic based colouring, to the more accurate yellow that's going on there. He also has a much more comic styling out of all the figures. Both these two really have a much more comic styling than any of the other figures. I mean, obviously Wolverine, as he came before, really doesn't change a great deal, and you can't really differentiate between what would be comic style for him and an animated style as such, but these two really stand out, the White or Storm here and Bishop themselves. So we'll get a closer look at them in just a minute, but just wanted to show you them with the others to show some of the differences. And obviously clear ones straight away are that peg holes are obviously gone. So previous versions obviously had lots of different peg holes, both at the elbows. They do not appear on these figures. Storm had a little bit less there with those single joint elbows, but you can see she had pegs for her knees there, but does not this time around. So that's it. They're all pretty similar-ish, but very much of a style that is, as I said, animated for these two figures just now. So we'll dive in, get a closer look at them, and compare bits and bobs. Even the blaster, you can see quite a different size there for Bishop's blaster. Absolutely ridiculously huge. Even though his holster on his shoulder really isn't that much difference. And he's certainly had a chop on the old mullet from before to this very sharp, slick kind of golf ball, like kind of sharp, spiky haircut there. So yeah, looking cool. Let's move the old ones out the way and we'll dive in with the new. And let's get a look at the packaging first and foremost for these. Storm, as you can see, comes with the animated style for her, and very reflective of that in the actual figure itself. We've got the X-Men 97 logo up at the top of the screen, obviously showing all the other characters. And Storm on the back, there we go, Magneto, Rogue, and Gambit still to go, or still to arrive. But yeah, very much a comic style based figure to go with, sorry, comic, or cartoon based style for this show. UPC for Storm, if it's helpful, is there. And let's get a look at Bishop, Marvel's Bishop, as it's stated. We've got the X logo in the background, and of course his very animated style there on this figure. On the back, same stuff. His logo, you can see the holstered weapon, which does look good. And quite a cool stylized version of Bishop overall. There's Bishop's UPC, should that prove to be helpful. So let's get a look at Storm first and foremost. A little bit more interest there in what we can do for her because of the swap out aspect. She's very easy to swap out. The head certainly pops off pretty easily. So in terms of the comic style on her, let's move this out of the way actually, let's get a close-up on that face and just see a little bit more what's going on. So we've got a nice little touch there. We've got the lightning earrings, same on the previous versions, a little bit of splodgy paint on the neck, but otherwise pretty good. We've got some nice detail on the eyes and on the lips, and of course that huge crest of frothy fondant hair going on there. We've got the X logo up at the top, a
then moving down the rest of the figure, small little belt. Not a great deal else. She's solid, solid white. Of course, she's got soft goods fabric, which has been used before on many Storms. Kind of messily done there. What you could do is map that round to the other side and you would just see this, so you could take off the hands and swap the sides around and it might be a little bit easier, but it's actually stitched into the back and underneath the figure, so, or glued on I should say, so yeah, you're kind of stuck there in some ways as to what can be done. So the rest of the figure, just again, just to give you a little blast from the side, just make out those eyebrows there. Nice facial sculpt. A solid looking figure. Now again, as I mentioned, you can swap out that head sculpt. So if I pop the old one off, pop the new on. Oh, sorry, pop the old off. Pop the old one. The new off, put the old on. You can see, just for completeness, you could have a perfectly viable Storm with that more punky head sculpt there if you wanted, if you so desired to have it that way. It certainly moves the figure, frees up the figure a little bit more at the neck because of all the hair, but it fits and there's some functionality there, so that's an option if you want to. But there's a lot of hair going on here in this figure, and you can see up at the top of her neck there's a ball joint. I'll pop that back on. There we go. Let's turn back on. If we notice the neck joint up at the top, so there's a pretty good range of motion all the way forward. That's pretty crazy, really. Now, it will not go back, obviously, because there's giant mane of hair, so you're stuck that way, but you will get to the sides, so that'll give you some movement there. You can see up at the top, there is a hinge for the top of the shoulders. She's got a single joint at the elbows, and wrists have standard, pretty classic articulation, both swivel and back and forth. We've also got this upper ab crunch. Nothing else, no waist crunch. We've got a thigh swivel up at the top, as well as these pins up at the top of the thighs. We've got double joints in the knees, no pins of course, and rocking ankles and pecs. So a pretty solid figure overall. It does look really good. It's certainly one that I think the animation will bring a lot more people into the fandom and enjoy, that's for sure. But a solid, solid Storm. We've had plenty of Storms over the years in all sorts of colours, white and black. So a pretty solid one overall. Let's. Anyway, I should actually mention she also comes with not only these open hands here, but she also comes with two swap out fists. So if you want to fist on her, you can do. Let's get a look at Bishop. Bishop has two swap out hands. Now just to be clear, I think what we've got is fisted one hand and the other hand holds the weapon. This is more really so that these two swap out hands, that if you wanted to hold the pistol in this, or the rifle in this hand and then carry it in that one, that is potentially what that hand is for. There's a lot of kind of room there, and it looks like a gripping hand for a trigger finger, but it doesn't really. It's more to just carry the weapon overall. I'll try and show you what I mean in just a second. So in terms of facial sculpt, let's get a look at this. And again, a really nice M-looking kind of slice down his face on that tattoo. And it is a very matte finished face. Really, really nicely done. Eyebrows, hair is very cool. And we've got his big trademark scarf as well, coming down the figure. You could take that if you want, it is removable. We've got the white stripes coming down the figure, not the white stripes, the yellow stripes I should say, down to the giant X on the belt, and again down the leg and down to the boots. Let's get a look at that pistol. So you've got quite a bit of detail in there. Again, very, very different to the previous Bishop's weapon. Much more a pistol than what was a rifle before. Let me just bring that in there just to show you the difference in size again and comparison. So, yeah, And that's what I mean about the way to hold the weapon. That's what those other two hands generally do. So yeah, quite a nice weapon there, but very animated style and flat. If you wanted to pop that off, you could. And that can fit in that holster as such. And that's how he would have it. But as I mentioned, what you can do, you can swap out the fist to the other trigger finger. And these are removable, by the way, these little parts of the gloves. And then also, you can add in this other hand, which looks like a trigger finger, but it's not. And you can then have what I was trying to get towards was this. So once we pop these out, and again, put this pistol in this hand, quite a soft, pliable plastic for the hands, more than normal. It feels a little soft, and that allows you to kind of grip the weapon like that. That's potentially what that hand was really designed for, because it doesn't grip the pistol piece at all. So pretty solid, nice few options with them. His head is on a ball joint up on top of that neck. There is no neck articulation. It's just on that ball joint. But a great sculpt and a great scarf. And underneath that, we can then get onto the shoulders. And you can see under these little plastic, slightly movable pieces, but they really have a bit of a hinge tucked way up underneath. You can just about see that in there, which is glued on. So it leaves a bit of a weird baggy gap at times, but it's intended to be stuck. You've then got that on that hinge there. You've then got a bicep swivel, double joints at the elbows, and down to both swivel and back and forth on those wrists. You will see his ab crunch, once we move the scarf out of the way, is pretty sick. Quite a lot of room on that overall. And then we've got the usual stuff. Pegs up at the top of the legs, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees. We've also got a boot cut and rocking ankles and peckles. That's it for Storm and Bishop. Two pretty good figures from the upcoming animation, starting very soon actually. So we'll find out more about these guys, and more figures have already been announced and more to come. But pretty solid overall. Definitely ones I think you'll probably want to pick up. But that's it. Hopefully that helps in your buying decisions. And we'll see you for more figure reviews coming up. Cheers.